Hey everyone, Terry Green TV here. So in my last video, today's prayer, what it was called, I said we would discuss supplements, nutrition a little bit. So remember, the platform is just not about a spiritual journey, but also a physical journey, which helps you in all aspects of life. I believe physical fitness, I've been off of it for a while and just starting to get really back into it. Physical fitness helps you mentally, physically. Keeps you fit, healthy. Cardio keeps your heart, lungs, all the important stuff. It keeps you as strong as possible. And then, of course, the spiritual, helps the mind, enlightens, mind, body, and soul, as they say. So we're going to start this video off with a prayer. If you do not want to participate in a prayer or hear the prayer, skip through it and then hear about supplements and nutrition, that's totally up to you. But we're going to start off with a prayer. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, call upon you today to go ahead and reach your hands out to all those who need it, all those who need to hear your voice and feel your presence during troubling times in their life. Or is it to help them with an addiction or shelter? If they're hungry, that you provide them food. Whatever their ask and needs are, when you hear their prayers and you know their hearts, we know that you, Lord, can make everything possible through your Son, Jesus Christ. So we ask you today to lift those up that need to hear this message. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so if you like what we're doing, like and subscribe. So here is what I generally do. So what you got to understand is the human body can only process so much stuff, right? So how do we get the proteins we need? So theoretically, to build muscle, you need to get 1 gram of protein per body weight. So if you're 200 pounds, you need 200 grams of protein. And eating protein-filled foods all day long, and I'll get to that in a second, how that works. You're just going to jam up the extra calories, things like that. So I use supplements. So I use a whey protein powder, one after a workout and one in the evening. Sometimes I don't eat dinner. I just take a protein shake. It's about 30 grams of protein per shake. So I get my 60 grams from there. In the mornings, I eat oatmeal with peanut butter. So that's 16 to 20 grams of protein there. Lunch or dinner, I'm really starting to get back into like brown rice, vegetables, and fish. So that's just more protein that you can take in. I also strongly recommend after a workout, a post-workout supplement that's filled with BCAAs, branched chain amino acids. So your muscles and body will need that to replenish. So they're the two things I generally take on a daily basis. The third thing I take on a daily basis is emergency. So if you ever seen it, it's like a high dosage of vitamin C. This era with COVID and things like that, it's good to keep our bodies plenished with vitamin C. It also has a lot of B6, B12 in it as well. I don't think a lot of people really realize the benefit of that, but it's more of an energy drink. So, and it's not chalk with sugar. So, I recommend that as well. So, there are the three things I do: whey protein, a post-workout shake that is a it almost tastes like fruit punch, but it's full of BCAAs, and emergency for those vitamin C's and B6 and B12. So that's what I kind of do. And and how do you process all that without your body just basically, if your body can't use it, it processes it and wastes it, right? So for proteins to actually, for your body to absorb protein, you need a carbohydrate. So there is two types of carbohydrates. There is a fast-acting carbohydrate, which is your whites, right? Your white rice, your white pasta, things of that nature. They are good for a quick energy boost pre-workout meal. Because whatever your body doesn't use is carbohydrates, it then turns into sugar. And then whatever that doesn't use, it stores the body fat. So if you're like me, I'm 40 years old, that's kind of something to really watch, is what type of carbohydrates you're ingesting, what times of day that you're ingesting them in. But your body needs carbohydrates to help process the protein. So if I eat fish, I'll eat it with brown rice. I eat oatmeal with peanut butter. I use raw cut steel oats, so that way I'm getting the good carbohydrates I need. So that's something to really keep in mind. So you want to stagger your meals 3 to 4 hours apart, depending on what you're trying to do. If you're trying to build lean muscle, you don't want to take a lot of high sugary foods in. So when you're looking at your supplements, look for things that are not high in sugars and salts and things like that, because you don't want the extra sugar, right? So they're kind of my suggestions of what to do. I guess the next video we can talk about like what type of workouts I like to do or what type of workouts you should do. Again, I'm 40. So, you know, it's a little different for me at my age. As I get older, you know, I see the benefits of different style workouts. I was strictly typical weightlifter, more into bodybuilding slash powerlifting for a long time. And then I'm starting to see the benefits of more of a compact or combo move exercises. For a while, I did some boxing, MMA, kickboxing. I enjoy those workouts as well. But so I'm starting to see more of compound movement style workouts to help me stay physically fit, cardio fit, and you know, to keep me moving. So they're my suggestions, and we'll talk more about workouts later. And one thing I do want to touch on before we go is you got to remember at the age of 31, 30 to 31, especially in men, you start losing testosterone. It's just human nature. And as we get older as well, one thing we got to keep remember is we start losing muscle tone and definition. It's just how your body works. So the longer you work out, the things that you put in your body for the right fuels, the supplements, you're making sure you're taking the right supplements and you're taking them consistently at around the right times that your body can maximize it. You know, the longer we stay fit and healthy, and it's all on us. And we just got to remember, we all can't beat Father Time. And sometime in our life that it's going to expire when God's willing for us says we completed our mission here on earth. So in the meantime, let's make it the best that we can, right? So let's remember spiritual, physical, and keep that mind healthy. Everyone have a great, blessed day. Terry Green TV.